Now, people on both sides of this debate say that this bill would not have prevented the tragedy at Sandy Hook Elementary, but supporters say it could help save other lives someday. A little over a year ago, Nicole Hockley lost her 6-year-old son, Dylan, in the massacre at Sandy Hook Elementary School in Newtown, Connecticut. Tuesday, she was in New Hampshire supporting a bill that she believes would close a loophole in firearm sales requiring criminal background checks for all transactions.
And it doesn't matter whether I'm a gun owner or not, or whether I'm a Republican or a Democrat. I'm weary of the constant fighting between gun control and gun freedom. As a people, why can't we focus less on our differences and more on our similarities?
The bill would focus on private sales of firearms to include gun shows and the internet. Opponents say it scales back Second Amendment rights.
What happened in Sandy Hook? God bless them kids there. That's a shame that it happened. Should have never happened. But this here law would never, ever in a million years correct what went on over there. This bill goes after law-abiding citizens.
This is a bad idea. It's a bad idea on multiple fronts. It's a bad idea because it's a gun registry and set in place for that to happen.
But Mark Barden, whose son was also murdered at Sandy Hook, said this violence needs to end somewhere.
One day, my little Daniel's death will no longer be just an enormous tragedy for us. It will be a moment of transformation for a nation that has somehow become too accepting of this endless stream of senseless shootings, each of which leaves families devastated and communities terrorized.
Opponents say this bill would also hurt the economy and cost jobs while doing little to keep guns out of the hands of criminals. Reporting live in Concord, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.